One, two, three, My baby don't mess around because she loves me so, and this I know for sure. But does she really wanna, but can't stand to see me walk out the door. Don't try to fight the feeling, cause the thought alone is killing me right now. Thank God for mom and dad for sticking two together, cause we don't know how. Come on.
Hello and welcome to Trevor's final episode of Cougar Television. Do not adjust your set. I'm not on a green couch. My hair is this gray. It's been approximately 20 years since my last episode, but we're back for one final run. As I record this, it's early 2023 in the springtime. I digitized a bunch of old DV tapes that I had in a box, as well as some DVDs, and threw them together on a timeline and figured I'd put them on the internet so everybody could check it out. And just so that I have a digital copy for the future. You know, CTV was a lot of fun for me. I spent 3 years there, started as a staff member, somebody that transferred to the College of Charleston. It was a really good way to meet people and explore the campus, go to a lot of events, and just be a goofball. You know, I studied communications in college because I had to pick something, and one of my favorite things to do was run around back home with friends in backyards and make home movies and stuff like that. And to be able to do it as a job in Charleston was a lot of fun. And then I think it did help my career down the line too, so. Anyway, enough blabbering. First up, we got a classic intro, and then where it all started for me, the first segment I think I did, the half jog.
From the hustle and the bustle and the downtown scene to the fun and the sun out of Folly Beach, sitting in the traffic out in Mount P, living west of the Ashley. The hustle and the bustle of the downtown scene to the fun and the sun at a Folly Beach, sitting in the traffic out in Mount P, living west of the Ashley. CTV for you and me. Hustle and the bustle of the downtown scene to the fun and the sun at a Folly
Beach. Next, we have a very important public service announcement on a topic that is of most importance to CFC students, the half jog.
Oh, it's such a perfect day. I'm glad I spent it with you. Oh, such a perfect day. You just keep me hanging on. You just keep.
No? Well, then consider yourself lucky. The Grid Street layout in Charleston is a breeding ground for jaywalking, and the half jog is your best defense against any kind of accident.
Well, wait a minute. What is the half jog?
Well, I'm glad you ask. You see, many people are unfamiliar with what exactly the half jog is.
Say Paul here wanted to cross the street. The first thing he would do is to look to his left and to his right, and then he would begin to cross. Upon crossing, he sees a car.
Oh!
But don't worry, this is when the half jog comes into play. First, he raises his arms, and then he quickens his pace. This enables him to cross the street without harm. With a smile and a wave, the half jog is complete.
And people actually do this half jog?
Oh yes, people do it all the time. Here are some real life examples.
Life in the fast lane, sure to make you lose your mind. Life in the fast lane.
So now that we know what the half jog is, let's see what people on the street have to say about the subject. Opinion on the half jog?
The what?
The half jog.
The half jog? half jog. They're gonna jog the half jog about what?
How many times do you half jog a day on average?
That's a good one.
Do you remember your very first half jog?
I do. It was when I was about 18 and I was crossing the streets in New York, and I got about 3/4 of the way and there was about 20 cars ready to go and I just sprinted.
Good. Yeah. There should be more people like you in the world.
Just keep going and hope they don't hit me.
So you go slow across the street?
Yeah, just to make them mad.
Now, do you ever use the half jog technique when crossing the road?
Yeah.
Use it a couple times a day?
A fair portion, yeah.
Well, it's strikingly clear that many Charlestonians are very dangerously uninformed about the HJ. To get another perspective, I sat down recently with an expert on the subject.
Now, Hal, many people regard you as the godfather of the half jog. If you could you please explain the importance of the half jog in today's society?
Well, for me, the half jog is about more than getting out of the way when a car is coming.
Uh-huh.
The half jog is about showing a certain amount of courtesy. You're not saying, oh, I'm going to take my time and I'm going to stroll across the street. The half jog means you're in your car, you've got somewhere to go, I've got somewhere to go, I'm walking, I'm not driving, so maybe I'm not going to be as fast as you, but I'm going to do my best to get out of your way in a manner that is not embarrassing.
If there was one thing you could say to people who don't half jog, what would that be?
I guess the one thing I would have to say is, you know, is take a look around, man. Take a look around and realize that you're not the only person with somewhere to go.
Tell us about www.halfjog.com.
Well, you know, I became aware of the internet about 4 months ago. And it occurred to me that this was an absolutely, absolutely incredible way to spread, to spread not only information about the half jog, but to spread the spirit of half jog, if you will.
The half jog. I think we all learned something today, and hopefully you found a better way to cross the street more safely. Back to you guys on the couch.
Yeah. Wasn't that half jog amazing?
Yes, it was, Ben. Yes, it was, Ben. If you're thinking to yourself, man, I could really go for some more of that Halford Jacobowitz character, stay tuned. There's more of that actor later in the show. You know, these were all recorded in the early 2000s. It was an interesting time. There, you know, it was post 9/11, the beginning of the Iraq and Afghanistan wars. It was a time before smartphones and social media really took off. But of that era, probably the most memorable thing was the creation of the chess robot cinematic universe. I mean, that'll just go down in the history of Western civilization as a really pivotal thing. So, of course, we've got to honor Chess Robot. We've got three skits back to back. Chess Robot takes a walk around town. He is reunited with his creators. But first, Chess Robot is born.
You out there in TV land might not know that we have a senior science correspondent. Oh, but we do. And here's Igor Vodkalov to tell you about his newest creation.
Oh, hello. I am Igor Vodkalov, and this is my non-English speaking associate. You see, we are former NASA scientists who, because of a recent miscalculation, have been given indefinite leaves of absence. Yeah. And so, while we were sitting at home watching our ESPN The Deuce, we saw Garry Kasparov and Deep Jr. square off on a chessboard, computer program, versus great Russian chess player. We decided to create something more than just a chess program. something that people wanted to be, that women wanted to sleep with and us, and that could take your little sister out on a date. The end result was Chess Robot.
Version 1.0.
You see, it all started when, at first, Chess Robot, he showed so much promise. Like your atypical Russian, he actually won things, got things done, did not back down to those capitalist Americans. Sadly though, Chess Robot's just constant victories went to his head. He became like Ivan Drago in Rocky IV. He never prepared, he never focused on strategy. It all just fell apart. Robot, once again, Chess Robot, version 1.0, went through amazing highs, but then horrible lows. And because we foolishly forgot to put a Russian personality matrix into his personality mainframe, he could not handle it.
Sharp enough to draw blood from a stone.
In the end, Chess Robot was too human to be a robot, but too much of a robot to be human. Sorry, if I had vodka, I would cry right now.
Stone and chain, he broke out of every prison. Well, the boots mount the staircase, the doors flung back open. He's not there for you. Not there for his reason. Some say he once killed a man with a guitar string. He's been seen at the table with kings. Well, he once saved a baby from drowning. There are those that say beneath his coat there are wings.
Next stop, Hollywood!
Alright, on to a bit of less humorous news. Last week we lost our good friend Chess Robot, and we were able to find this piece of footage left before he passed, so take a look.
Far away from me. All right.
I just can't see.
Everything was perfect. Chess Robot quit all his old habits and even got himself a beautiful girlfriend.
Are you nobody to somebody really loves you? So find yourself somebody to love. Sure.
Chess Robot even started reading the newspaper every morning. Well, I mean, it was the Post and Courier, but that's not all he read. Look, watch. He read the book on Vietnam and some more about the Post and Courier. Well, I mean, look, the Post and Courier, yes, it's not news, but cut him some slack. He's trying. But you know, sometimes I think he was just faking it all. But that's okay. We love him anyway.
Oh, you gotta love that, them all getting back together. If you enjoyed that, stay tuned. We got some more Chess Robot down the line. But next up are some more favorites. You know, these are all products of their time as well. The MTV show Pimp My Ride inspired Pimp My Library. The advent of reality TV inspired A Life and Times. But first, I've got a question. Tennis, anyone?
There's only one way to settle this.
Itself.
Kids, welcome to Pimp My Library. I'm Display.
Call it what you wanna call it. I'm a big alcoholic.
Coming right at you. We got this girl. Her library is whack and needs a whole new redo. She wants it pimped out with all the new features because, you know, it is the new millennium. And we're going to go to Julie because we pimping her library today. She don't know it, but we about to go get Julie and pimp her library. Yo, yo, Julie, hello!
Oh my gosh, I can't believe it! I'm so excited!
Yo, I'm just blank and I'm about to pimp your library!
I can't believe you're here.
Well, girl, let's go and let's go pimp that library.
Good, because this library's whack.
Julie is a freshman at the College of Charleston and needs a hip place to study. I've got some of the best experts that's going to help her out and make her library pimp.
Yo, what's up? I'm P-Money.
My ideas walk through closet doors and roam all over Coliseum floors.
Yo, CFC, what's up? I'm T-Slice.
VIP. Let's kick it.
Julie needs a really spacious place for her study. What do you have in mind?
I checked out her old library. That was whack.
It was whack.
The staircase is all small, can't see nothing. So what I'm thinking, I'm gonna put a rotunda in there.
Oh, they don't call you the architect for nothing, boys.
Snap! What you got going?
Well, you know, I'm thinking all those old bookshelves were dark and all in the dark and stuff. I'm thinking brand new bookshelves, electronic, with laser beams so they can smoosh together, fit double the books.
Oh, snap, that'd be awesome. That'd be tight.
Yo, T-Slice, man, I'm also thinking, remember those old desks at her old library?
Oh, man.
So dark, you couldn't see anything?
Yeah.
I'm thinking about getting brand new desks, maybe putting a little faded light up there so you can actually see what you're reading.
Yo, my girl really likes coffee and needs it for her study. What could we maybe add in for a little special effect?
Yeah, you know, she likes that coffee bean, so I was thinking maybe a little coffee joint in the back. Her friends could chill out, you know, relax between classes. That'd be awesome.
All right, let's get to work.
Let's do it.
Thank you.
so much, CTV, for pimping my library. We all know the old one was black, and now we got this awesome place. We can get it some coffee. We can see now. It's all good. Call it what you wanna call it. I'm up.
Well, that skit didn't really have a definitive ending. You kind of expected Rocky to maybe like run up some stairs to some music and maybe people, you know, chase after him, but instead just kind of, you know, trail in.
Hey, and welcome to CTV this week. I'm in Hara Chester Jones.
And I'm Trevor Brightman.
Do you ever wonder what college kids do with their spare time?
No, not really.
But here's the life and times of Matt Crosby.
His last name's Crosby and his first name's Matt. He lives next door and he has a cat. He's a senior and he's from Tennessee. I'm so glad he's friends with me. The life and times.
Crosby!
There's that other.
Why not me? Why not anybody?
Matt,
why,
Blake?
Why does it have to be Blake? Why is Blake have
You're
to be the
You're not even at his show before auditions.
I didn't
even play
catch my
day.
Show. I recruited people.
Yeah, he was playing football like in his front yard.
In the fucking neighborhood.
See? Why I should be the coach?
Yeah. I'm away.
You did what?
I'm my beer on. So you can put this on TV.
That's why you have
Who's on third?
Sissy ball.
No, who's on third?
She didn't know who was involved. She just jumped straight to asking you to be the coach. I mean, that seems a little...
Matt, I ran the interim...
Your brother Blake, yeah, him.
High school.
Oh, that's just... you shouldn't tell people.
All I love is to you.
Can you smoke on CTV?
I'll pretend that I'm kissing you. The lips I...
Remember me? Were you asleep? I'm sorry.
Please. You have to be the star of everything, okay?
And hope that my dreams will come true.
I was having
a smoke break.
Matt enjoys candlelight dinners, mid-afternoon spooning, and long walks along Folly Beach. Contact CTV for more information.
Would you like to earn your degree from home? Well, with CTVI, you can earn your degree in up to 6 weeks. Take a moment and listen to what some of our satisfied customers have to say.
Thanks to CTV, I got me a job as a gunsmith. Blowed off my right arm. Thanks, I guess.
Thanks to CTVI, I no longer take my clothes off for money. Now I take my clothes off for a lot of money.
I used to be a producer at CTV, but now I'm a toll booth operator in the inner city. Thanks.
After I got my degree in banquet serving, I was able to quit my job as an exotic dancer. Thanks, CTV.
I used to be a bartender at Studio 54. Now I clean up after retarded kids.
Just look at all the programs we have to offer.
Accounting, auto mechanics, bridal consulting, computer repair, electrician, rodeo clown, gunsmithing, banquet service, heating, air conditioning, hotel management, asbestos installation, high school diploma, locksmithing, medical claims billing, medical transcription, cabana boy, paralegal, private investigator, real estate appraisal, paraselling, chess grandmaster, middle school diploma, carpet bagging, regular clown, whistleblowing, freedom fighting, state police officer, vagabonding, gold mining, civil war recreational assistant, stream puppeteering, silicone breast inspector, prison gardener, town drunk, yellow journalist, toll booth operator, cleaning up after retarded children.
Stop wasting your life away. Call CTVI.
Trampolines. Children's plaything or secret backyard killers. McFadden?
secret backyard killer.
Oh, you're such a stupid idiot. They're just children's playthings. If you can jump on it, like a normal
person. You know how many people die a year jumping on trampolines?
Well, then they should just jump up and down.
Are you aware?
Why did you do all these crazy tricks?
Are you aware?
Shut up!
People, please.
I know, okay?
Please, wait. I think, I don't, how is it that we have gone from international and national crises to a silly question about trampolines?
Trampolines are very important. There are many people.
It has nothing to do with what is going on in the world right now.
Well, it's very important.
The more important issue is facing us at the moment.
People are dying.
Countries that begin with Z. Go, 3 seconds.
Zimbabwe, Zen,
no,
Susan.
Zaire!
Quagmire, come on.
There are only two. I wrote a very important master's thesis on this while I was attending the...
No.
It starts with an N.
It's how it's spelled in the phone book.
There is no country phone book.
Well, if there were, it would say Zealand New.
But there isn't. You are making things up. You are a total idiot.
Ah, the joy of 24-hour cable news and debate shows. At least things have gotten a lot calmer and more civilized since then. But you gotta love those Life and Times clips. We had a lot of fun on Elizabeth Street. Anywho, as promised, there is more Chess Robot on the docket up next. While digitizing, I found some never-before-aired behind-the-scenes footage of me doing an intro and tag that I don't think we ever used. So I'm gonna include that here. There's the romance of Chess Robot getting a girlfriend, a certain time travel adventure, and a silent film, which for some reason was cut short because we ran out of tape. And back then, you just dealt with what you got. So without further ado, Chess Robot returns.
So the traffic dies down a little. I should have been doing a funny voice the whole time. Ready? Hi, I'm Gideon Yago for CTV News. Today we're going to be talking to Liz Dangle, who goes to the College of Charleston and faces a lot of adversity because she dates a chess robot. Is that good?
I have to say he is pretty cute, but he's an excellent listener. He's great at snuggling. I mean, he lives in a box, so I don't see what there isn't to like.
Liz, do you find it difficult dating a chess robot here at the College of Charleston today?
I mean, it's been hard, I'm not going to lie. People aren't accepting of human-robot relations, but... And his drinking has affected my family a lot, too, but we're all trying to work past it. I mean, it's hard. He drinks a lot and takes a lot of support to get through that. But we're trying.
Thanks for sitting down with us. We really appreciate it.
Yeah, that's right, freshman. You just better make sure we got some brewskis tonight when we're watching the game. Wait, hold on a second. I'll get back to you. Liz? What are you doing here?
Taylor, I'm here with Chess Robot.
Don't call me Taylor, call me Guns. Respect.
I told you that I'm dating Chess Robot now.
What kind of a freak are you?
We love each other.
You love each other? It's a robot! It's a chess robot!
It's version 1.0. I'm sorry. We broke up months ago.
But I thought we'd always still get back together. I mean, come on, we had the whole thing with, you know, Room Raiders. I thought we hit it off real well. Come on!
Sorry. This is who's special in my life right now.
Wait a second. That's even a real chess robot! This is Paul Heslop wearing a box!
No, it's not. It's not Paul.
Listen, whatever. I don't have time for you and your chess robot.
I'm sorry, Taylor. Me and chess robot have a future. You and I don't.
What, with an alcoholic kid in a box?
We're in love. That's all I can say.
You and I? Through. Never again. Off. Over. Done. What? What's that, freak boy? Huh? Huh? You little robot, you think that's funny? You think you can make comments? Well, you're a freak. And I'm the man around here. Y'all have a nice life, bitches.
In my mind, I'm gone to Carolina. Can't you see the sunshine? Can't you just feel the moonshine? Ain't it just like a friend of mine to hit me from behind? Yes, I'm gone to Carolina in my mind. Karen, she's a silver sun, you best walk her away.
She's like, all right, so I'll do the tack there at the end. You're on?
Yep.
So as you can see, dating a chess robot in today's society is anything but easy. For CTV News, I'm Gideon Yago. We'll see you back here at 10 to the hour every hour here on CTV.
Sorry, that was a really bad, this is a really bad shot.
Really happened in Ford's Theater. Let's take a look.
What in God's name do you think that you are doing, boy? This is a non-smoking establishment for inmates, like you will be soon. Now, let's establish the facts. Is your name John Wilkes Booth?
Yes.
Right. Were you at Ford's Theater?
No.
Boy, don't lie to me.
Sir, I know my rights. I want my lawyer. I want to talk to...
You want your lawyer?
Miranda versus Arizona.
Shut up! Miranda versus Arizona has not been decided yet. It is 1865 and it will be practically 100 years before the Supreme Court hears oral arguments on that case. March less publishes its decision. So until then, you don't get no lawyer. Do you understand me, boy? Now, you's gonna start answering my questions. Is your name one John Wilkes Booth?
Yes, sir.
Now, were you at Ford's Theater the night that President Abraham J. Lincoln was assassinated?
No, sir.
Oh, you weren't at Ford's Theater, were you?
No, sir.
Oh, really? Yeah. That's funny. That's really funny. You know why that's so funny?
Why is that?
Because you're lying to me! And I hate liars! You know why it is I hate liars? Do you know why, boy?
No.
Shut up, I'm talking to you! Shut your mouth! I got me a witness who says you was at Ford's Theater in the booth with President Lincoln and you suffocated the SOB to death.
Sir, I don't even know who President Lincoln is.
Oh, God, don't give me no crap. All right. You maintain you didn't suffocate one, President Lincoln?
No, sir.
That's good. What if I was to say to you, I got me a witness who says, tried to poison with a poisonous drink. What would you say about that?
I would call you a filthy liar.
Oh, would you? All right. You says you wasn't at Ford's Theater, but I got me yet another witness who says what you did do was try to beat him to death with a futuristic-looking metal rod. Did you or did you not try to beat him to death with a futuristic-looking metal rod?
Sir, I don't even know what a futuristic-looking metal rod is.
Don't you lie!
For the last time, I didn't strangle the president. We've been going over this for the last 2 hours.
You didn't strangle the president?
No, sir.
You know, I don't believe you, Nancy Pants.
What is a Nancy Pants?
Didn't we go over that half hour ago?
Wait a minute. Yes, we did. I'm sorry. You're right there.
And why can't you admit that you strangled the president?
Because we all know he was shot!
Oh. How would you know that? Unless you was there. Newspaper accounts ain't been released to how President Lincoln was killed. But somehow you know he was shot. Well, I find that mighty peculiar for a man who wasn't at Ford's Theater. Now, what in the hell do you have to say about that, Mr. John Wilkes Booth, who claims he wasn't at Ford's Theater?
I don't know who shot the president.
I don't want your lies. I want the name of your co-conspirator. And I want it now. Because if I don't get it, in the next 5 seconds, there's going to be a hanging, and your scrawny, ugly neck is going to be in the noose.
It was a robot, okay? Is that what you want to hear? You want to hear that it was a futuristic, boxy robot sent back through time to kill the president?
And you expect me to believe that a giant, boxy-moving robot went back in time by some neo-Nazi Confederate types to kill the man who freed the slaves?
Sir, you can believe what you want.
Do you have
I'm telling
one?
You the
Shut up! I'm talking! Merv! Get the noose. This SOB's ready to get himself hung.
You may have recognized a certain actor so far tonight, that being one Paul Heslop. Paul and I have known each other a long time. We went to elementary school, middle school, high school. We went to College of Charleston together, roommates, worked at CTV together, worked at the American Theater together, and stay in touch to this day. He's a great guy, comes from a great family, has a great family of his own right now with his two girls and his wife, and really fortunate to have him in my life. But anyway, next up is some of my favorite Paul skits.
Hey guys, welcome back to CTV for our fourth show this season. You know, Halloween's coming up. What are you gonna be for Halloween?
I think a samurai. What are you gonna be?
Raggedy Ann.
Oh, did you know these, like, a bunch of people escaped from a mental institution? And luckily, we caught it on camera.
Oh.
Check it out.
Gosh, yeah. Really? Yeah. Okay.
Kind
Wow. Hopefully those people were caught and locked up.
New York, it's illegal to throw balls at somebody's head for fun.
Well, you remember when Zach Morris was the only person who had a cell phone?
In fact, I do.
Yeah, those were the days. Unfortunately, those days are gone.
Well, recently, there's been a disturbance at the Calhoun Annex. So we sent our CSI team out to investigate. Let's see what happens.
X divided by 4 over Y is the square root of Z.
Oh, see, I thought it was X times 4 over Y.
Well,
you know, this calculus stuff, I really appreciate you staying late and helping me out. Big exam tomorrow, you know, I'd be screwed.
Hey, man. We're friendly for it, right?
Yeah.
Well, hey, I gotta run to the bathroom. I'll be right back.
All right.
Check out example number 5.
Okay.
So, did you finish example 5?
No! Just reached the Calhoun Annex. We've got like a 7.59er 240 code 10.
A code 10?
Something like
What's
this.
Going on here? Can y'all not see the caution tape?
Sorry. We're gonna have to get the dog out of here. Have to get a closer look. Let's get behind this caution tape.
Come on, let's go. Tight fit.
Look, pencil. Hold on.
Get the gloves.
Yeah, he's definitely dead. Looks like we've got ourselves a 20-year-old John Doe. Brown hair. Brown eyes. I say eat that ham for dinner.
What's that?
I thought the Green Buddha killer stopped killing 10 years ago.
Looks like evidence.
Look, what do we have here?
Looks like a number 2. The deadliest kind of
That was disgusting.
Yeah, that was a little hard to see.
That was disgusting.
Yeah, that was a little hard to see. If the killer came in, grabbed his book while he was studying, and just continuously hit him over the head.
But that wouldn't explain why he has stabs on his ankles.
But you guys were definitely right. As you can see, these stabs and abrasions, they were definitely caused by a number two. As you can tell from our blood sample, it did have many graphite poisonings inside of it, but we can tell that by the antibodies which are fighting the graphite.
So in your opinion, what was the cause of death?
It was pencil stabs, especially the ones to the jugular and to the ankle.
Thank you, Dr. Edwards.
Let's go.
We got a mystery to solve. What are you reading?
Oh my God.
What? Green Buddha killer died in prison yesterday?
We just lost our killer.
God, I'm thirsty. Hey, dirtbag! There's nothing to drink in here. All you got's a bunch of white wine, which makes me question your sexual orientation.
Don't call me dirtbag. I know we have nothing to drink, man.
What's with all the white wine, though?
It's Trevor's. You know how Trevor is.
Yeah. So what am I gonna drink?
I don't know, we have nothing, man.
Hey, you got a bottle of syrup, dude. Wouldn't it be funny if one of us drank that?
Dude, I'll give you $10 if you drink that syrup.
You're on, man.
Oh, also, I don't have the $10 on me, so I'll have to give it to you if you survive.
That's fine.
Alright.
That's fine.
Give me your knife.
Oh, yeah. The nice folks at Mini Leatherman makes some nice stuff here. Here. There you go. Open it up.
Thank you.
Go ahead, dirtbag. Let me scroll that.
I have a problem with my brain.
There you go. Come on, dirtbag.
I'm trying. You know, they're still.
You know, trying hard. Doesn't pay bills. All right, I'm not interested in your excuses. I want
you
to drink the syrup.
Do it?
Yeah, drink the syrup. Come on, be a man.
Can't even open it.
Can you open the bottle?
No.
Oh my God, what a pansy. God, look, how hard was that? Look, all right. Now, keep in mind, for reference, this is a very fine Harris Teeter light butter flavor, artificial, of course, reduced calorie syrup. Excuse me. Calories per serving? 100.
No, stop and drink it, dirtbag!
Serving? 12.
That's 12. Dirtbag, will you drink it?
You need some water, dude.
I need some pancakes, man.
Oh my God. You alright?
Yeah, dude, I'm fine.
You wanna play some Nintendo?
I'm just gonna go next door here.
Trevor, Paul really needs medical assistance right now.
Okay.
So I think what we should do is have you put the camera down. For God's sakes, get out of here!
Not as fun coming back up, guys. That's all I gotta say.
Here at CTV, we sacrifice a lot for you. We sacrifice our time, we sacrifice our sanity, we sacrifice
our legs.
Exactly. So the next time someone on your hall or on your street is saying, those people at CTV, they don't work hard. They're slackers. I want you to show them this.
So this is where we did that Abraham Lincoln skit.
There's me, John Wilkes Booth. There the table kind of fell out from under me. I kind of wasn't expecting it. Luckily, I didn't fall all the way down.
Prop malfunction.
Yeah. But we had a protective mat, so it was okay.
The next one, though, not so good.
Not so good. What happened was the chair kind of slipped out from under me. I wasn't expecting it to happen.
And there we go. And that's when your leg broke, right?
Yeah, right here, you can actually see the exact point where my leg breaks into two pieces. It took about 6.5 to 7 months of
intensive therapy.
Yeah, full body cast.
That's too bad, really. Well, you're a trooper for the team.
Well, you know, you gotta make sacrifices for TV. And Paul, I saw Trevor Brighton signing off.
The sacrifices Paul made for this program, for your entertainment. Hope you enjoy it. I think he got type 3 diabetes during that last one with the syrup. Up next, I've got a couple more clips. We're getting closer to the end. When Devon Chandler was a senior, I edited together a clip of some of her appearances throughout the years. For some reason, I chose a very mellow, rather dramatic Good Will Hunting type song, but it will be presented here in its original form, as well as some more work from the genius Ben Bird, and a couple other favorites. So I'm going to say the thing that Devon made sure nobody said on the intro, because she's not here to stop me. Check it out.
Someone's always coming around here, trailing some new kill. Says I seen your picture on a $100 bill. What's a game? A chance to you, him as one. With real skill, so glad to meet you, Angela.
Picking up the ticket shows, there's money to be made. Men, they should just jump up and down.
Go on, lose the game. It's the history of the trade. Did you add up all the cards left to play? To zero and sign up with the don't start me trying now. Cause I'm all over it, Angela. I can make you satisfied in everything you do. All your secret wishes could right now be coming true. Be forever with my poison arms around you. No one's gonna fool around with us. No one's gonna fool around with us. So glad to meet you, Angela. Thank you.
Devon. Are you Sockin?
I'm Sockin like Christopher Walken. Are you Sockin?
I'm Sockin like a clock. I'm tick-tockin'. Hey, Dave. Are you Sockin?
I'm so Sockin, I'm rockin'. Hey, Amy. You Sockin?
I'm Sockin even while I'm knockin'. Hey, Kate.
Yeah?
Are you Sockin?
I'm baking like Betty Crockett. I'm so Sockin. Trevor, you Sockin?
I've been Sockin since the days of Captain Kirk and Mr. Sparkin.
Hey guys, I'm Sockin.
What was that?
Dude, you're so not Sockin.
CTV.
We suck!
On CTV, you know we covered The View.
Star Jones in the house.
Mark Knapp tells it like it is.
Don't believe the lies.
Miss Horro's Jaffascopes.
For a change.
Our annual Carney Fiesta.
Funnel cake.
You take control with Talk to the Mic.
Don't believe the lies.
The lovely Dre and Kate show us how to cook a Thanksgiving meal.
Delicious.
The music of Tristan and Sharon live in studio.
It's not really live.
Shut up.
Don't you shut up.
Makeup, come here, I need some lipstick.
Oh my God.
You do not need to talk to the anchor. Finally!
Thank you.
Please.
And in 5, 4, 3.
Hi, and welcome to CTV. I'm Jaffa Miller.
And I'm Molly McLink.
His last name's Crosby and his first name's Matt. He lives next door and he has a cat. He's a senior and he's from Tennessee. I'm so glad he's friends with me. The life and time.
Crosby!
Have you ever felt your soul die? Sustenance here. I ran out of food. I miss my friend. He is dead. Fate took him away.
Stick around. We'll be right back.
Attention CTV fans. We have a special offer. Are you sick and tired of your cell phone wallpaper? Well, we've got you covered. We've got the custom pics for your celly to make you the coolest kid on your block. For Cougars Rock, simply text capital COU-781_5. For CTV rules, text CR %pound. For King Street Cobras, text CSK < %open parentheses. All to CTV@&E\DDL+. That's it. No catches.
$79.99 per month, 6-month limit.
Remember, those who slack are whack. Do it today.
And we're back.
All right, if you made it this far, there's only a couple more clips to go. Thank you for tuning in. I hope you had as much fun as I did putting this together. Drop me a line if it's been a while. I'm going to leave this online. Tell it or we all get canceled for whatever thing we may have done way back when. But yeah, thanks for tuning in. I got a couple more kind of random uncategorized clips, followed by one more Just Robot kind of conclusion and a credit sequence that kind of illustrates how much fun we had back then. And then after that, secret sneak preview of things to come. Thank you for tuning in. Take care.
Hello, I'm Trevor Brightman, and we're here at the beautiful South Carolina Aquarium here in Charleston, South Carolina. And today, we're going to be taking a look at all the magical things it has to offer, like birds. And fish. Here you can find fish of all sorts. Big fish, small fish, happy fish, sad fish, nice fish, angry fish, and many others.
Sorry, the Red Sox are playing again. Baseball is very exciting. And the Southies in Boston get almost excited about the Red Sox as I do about talking pillows.
Well, first of all, I like to make cardboard cutouts of the Rocket, and I like to burn the shit out of them.
We don't like the Rocket here in Boston.
I think he's
no mom. You got that right.
Yeah.
Who's the pitcher?
Pedro.
You got that right, yeah. Petey. It's beautiful. It's like music coming out of that guy's lips.
No.
Well, I like to go to Boston Market and get myself a whole chicken, and I eat it. And I drink about a case and a half of Sammy's.
Yeah.
Well, a case of Sammy's and a case of Sammy's light, because it gets bloating, you know?
Yeah.
I'm watching my weight. I work out. Want to see the gun?
I'm here with the creators of The Life and Times of Matt Crosby, that guy and his friend. Why did y'all, what was the inspiration for Matt Crosby?
Well, it came to me in a dream. I was sleeping one afternoon, and I just knew that we have to make A Life and Times of Matt Crosby. Simple as that, really.
What did you think about the progression of the character of Matt Crosby?
Well, I think Matt Crosby developed from episode 1 to episode 2 to episode 3 and the fourth unseen episode. It's really a touchy subject, but if the public had seen that last episode, they would have understood Matt Crosby as a human being. they would have understood the essence that is Matt Crosby.
Why did you cancel The Life and Times of Matt Crosby?
We decided to cancel The Life and Times of Matt Crosby, how do I say this? Because it was crap. The first version, I don't really know what to say about it. Maybe if you know Matt Crosby, it's funny. But, no, it kind
of
sucked.
Okay, so why did you cancel The Life and Times of Matt Crosby?
Have you seen it?
No.
It's awful. I mean, the first one, no, all of them are just, they don't make sense. They're so stupid. I don't know what they're thinking. Like, what the...
And how do you feel about Matt Crosby?
Who?
How did you feel when you learned that you were going to be the next Matt Crosby?
Well, I mean, obviously I was shocked. I mean, how could anybody replace Matt Crosby? Hello? Do the words pure gold mean anything to the people at CTV? Duh. I mean, we're not talking about James Crosby. We're not talking about Roger Crosby. We're not talking about Bing Crosby or even Crosby, Stills, and Nash. We're talking about Matt Crosby. The one, the only. No brainer.
Why, I happen to love The Life and Times of Matt Crosby. How could you cut it? Whoever cut it should be murdered. In fact, if I become president, I'll kill whoever cut it. That means you, Kate, Devon, or Phronsie. I'm coming after you.
And how do the both of you feel about Matt Crosby being canceled?
Devastated. There's no reason to get out of bed.
It's just horrible, you know? I mean, all the blood, sweat, and tears that went into that. They shoot down our dreams. I mean, it was right there. I was reaching for the sky, and it just fell down and collapsed.
How could they cancel the show when I have a contract?
Well, I guess your contract is void because the management canceled it. It wasn't funny enough.
Wait, can they really cancel shows like that?
I guess so. I mean, they did it, so what are you going to do now?
But I have a wife, I've got kids, I've got dogs. I mean, what am I gonna do? I got car payments, I got house payments, I got refrigerator payments, I got cabinet payments, I got roof payments. God, I'm gonna have to fake my death again. Oh, just stop the tape.
I am telling you, chemical weapons to the Arabs is the best way to make money.
I know.
Not English speaking compatriot. Oh my goodness. Oh! Did you order a pizza?
Yes, small.
Very good, very good. But I thought you couldn't speak English.
I take 9 classes.
Oh, very good, very good.
Nush.
Okay, it's coming on.
Hello, iGurmoTello. Hello, non-English speaking associate. If you are watching this, then you probably already know. I have committed suicide. Oh. I was living in the fast lane for too long. As much as I tried, I just could not handle all the booze, late nights, and the countless, faceless, and nameless women. Life, like chess, became a terrible game. A game I knew I just could not win. Stalemate. My love for you both, my creators, is so profound that it cannot even be put into words. You created me, and taught me the ways of life and chess, and for that, I am eternally grateful. I just wish that there was something I could do to repay my debt. But, alas, there is not. I find myself at the bottom of a horrible downward spiral. I am in a state of complete and utter despair. Goodbye, my friends. Goodbye. Regards. Chess Robot version 1.0. P.S. If you are wondering where you can find me, I have jumped off of the roof.
He's going to do what? He's going to kill himself! No! Chess Robot, no! You must not kill!
Thank you.
Check us out.
Or check out our website. Thanks a lot, guys.
I'm back. We are here at CTV. I'm Brittany. Sorry, Buster. I know my full sound. Use hit and directed by the likes of John. Use recitals of rewritten idols. Or scrawled in the hall like Anthony Michael. I like Land and Title. Just one of the boys on islands and islands.
I feel the dream.